Get those powders in the air! When I wake up, I'm gonna be the man who wakes up. When I go up,
I'm gonna be the man who goes up.
Raise your hands for life. You're from up there, wave your hands. Oh, up to room. I'm gonna be the man. Let's see you. Come on. It's all right, let's go on. Let's get dancing. Come on, you boy. Come on, let's get waving them.
Thank you.
but I can't let you go.
Music, Hans and Man.
Yeah.
your banner up in the air if you can hear me. At the very, very back. Further back, can you hear us?
We've got to need more volume, Adam. Yeah, if you don't mind the mic. Yeah.
So right at the very back, can you hear us? Just raise your banners up, right? Can you hear us now?
Good stuff.
Bring 1, 2, 3, raise your banners. 1, 2, 3, everybody. Once more, 1, 2, 3, raise your banners. Okay, we're going to start on a bit of a solemn note. We're just going to have a minute's silence for all the unborn children murdered in the last year since our last Rally for Life in Belfast. I'm going to take the music down off. So we're going to have a minute's silence. Competition between the provinces, is that all right? So,
come on, Ulster.
Come on, Ulster. Okay. We're going to do the orange trick, okay? I'm going to say pro-life, and I'm going to ask each province to repeat after me. Pro-life, that's right, yeah. Pro-life, okay? So, we won't start with Dublin, okay? We're going to have 5 provinces because it might be a bit unfair, Dublin, just being Dublin. So we'll start off first with Munster. So everybody from Kerry, from Cork, from Waterford, from Limerick, from Clare, right? We are... I'll give you one more shot. Okay, come on, Dennis and Helen, okay? Get Dennis and Helen from Kerry up there. We have Daniel from Cork, get your crowd moving. They're all Port Larrigan with Julie Walsh. Michael there from Clare, and all the people there from Limerick, Shane. I'm gonna get Kevin, put Kevin and Geraldine with Limerick, okay, as well. So give me more shot, okay. We are! Okay, we'll give you 9.5 out of 10 for that, okay. We'll go on to Connacht. Just have to remember my geography now. Right, we have Galway. We have Mayo. We have something else. We have Leitrim. We have Roscommon. There's one more, Sligo. Right, okay. We are!
Pro-life!
We are!
Pro-life!
Okay. I think you're just a little bit behind Munster, so you're going to have to try a bit harder. So come on, Aidan, Maria, Cormac, the Maddens, Edna and Eugene in Golliff, Eileen and Tommy in Mayo, the people in Roscommon and Leitrim, Bernie and the O'Haras, and what's the other county? Sligok, of course. Frank and John and Mary. Okay, 1, 2, 3, we are!
Pro-life!
We are!
Pro-life!
Okay, so far to draw, 9.5 each, right? We move on to Leinster. This might be more difficult to remember all these counties, okay? Well, Wexford, Wicklow, Leash, Carlow,
Kilkenny,
Westmeath, Loud,
Kilkenny, Offaly,
Kildare,
Kilkenny,
I'm forgetting, Kilkenny, don't forget the cats are beating.
Bushes, I see the bushes.
We are!
Brody, you've lost it, it's us.
It's up to the Dubs now to win it for us, alright? So the Dubs, we give you a province on yourselves, right? So don't let us down here, okay? We are! We are! We are! Okay, I think it's fair to say it's a draw. We give it a draw. No, we give it a draw. Okay. Right, listen, thank you very much. All of you are coming. We're just going to go straight into the speakers. We've kept the speakers to a minimum, bringing the pro-life message on campus, to the streets and everywhere people gather. She has also led a hugely important witness outside referral clinics where pro-life volunteers reach out to mothers and babies. She is one of the young pro-life leaders who will keep Ireland abortion free. Please give a warm Dublin welcome to Carolyn Johnson.
Thank you all so much for such a warm welcome. And what a joy-filled day this is. I can see you when I look around the crowd through the smiles on your face and say it all. And thank you all for making such a huge effort to be here today. I realise that people travel from all over the country. The importance of this day cannot be underestimated, as you probably know. The attack on Ireland is thick in the atmosphere. And the opponents of life, including the EU, the Labour Party, etc., are not shy about this fact. There is an urgency for every person here and who couldn't be here today to get involved in this fight. We must remember we are not only protecting the generation that are here today, we are protecting future generations. And there are two key elements to this, as you probably already know, and they are prayer and action. You may think that what you have to offer this very, very important witness is insignificant, but I tell you here, and I guarantee you, it absolutely is not. Almost 20 years ago, just 7 people came together to form Youth Defence, and they took action. And they defended this country from top to bottom and blitzed this country with the truth about abortion. More volunteers joined and took action. And they participated in every pro-life activity you can possibly imagine. From billboard campaigns to street information sessions to road shows, schools projects, etc. And they literally reversed the efforts of those who were doing all they could to introduce abortion into this country. Again, pro-life volunteers prayed and took action and stood at the doors of Mary Stopes Abortion Referral Agency, less than a mile from where we're standing now. And last January, I'm so pleased to say that one volunteer more stood there in the cold and offered true, true compassion and support to a young lady in a real crisis. And that baby who had scheduled to die in a couple of days is now due to be born this very day. Absolutely wonderful what can be achieved. So now I ask you, every single person here, to pray and to take action. There is something in this movement to suit every person and every lifestyle. For example, you can write letters, you can leaflet your housing estates, you can do the clinic work, lobby the politicians, do street information sessions. And I'd also like to announce, particularly for the young people here today, that on the 6th of July there will be a road show going around all the major towns and cities doing pro-life information work starting next Wednesday. I just say the horror of abortion is creeping into this country, and I absolutely emphasise the horror. Because if you have ever sat with a woman who was post-abortive, a post-abortive mother, while she wept and wailed for her unborn child that she will never see in this life, that is something that is imprinted into your soul forever. So I now ask you to commit or recommit your pro-life efforts. I ask you to look into the faces of the little children here today as I look into the face of my own little son and promise them from the depths of your soul that you will do everything you can, absolutely everything you can from this day forth, and keep Ireland abortion free. For a million more.
Thank you, Carolyn Johnson. Lads, can you hear me at the back? Can you hear us at the back? Is that okay? Light banner number white, the light banner with the white there, with the red. Can you hear me there? Just wave the banner from side to side if you can hear me. Maybe not. Anyway. Right, here we go. If people want to move up, maybe, people are finding it hard to hear at the back. Thank God, I suppose, for the size of the crowd. Just a couple of things just to mention. As many of you know, we've got great response from the Bishops of Ireland, which is absolutely fantastic. So 3 cheers for the Bishops of Ireland. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Just to read Cardinal Brady's message to us today. I commend all the Rally for Life committee on the marvellous work you are doing. Supporting the fundamental right of life for the unborn child is so important, and it is good to gather people to celebrate the precious gift of life. I send you my best wishes as you celebrate the Rally for Life in Dublin on the 2nd of July and wish the event every success. And just one more there from Bishop of Clogher. The people of the Diocese of Clogher are happy to join you in celebrating and cherishing the gift of life in all its forms, and wish you every success to your Rally for Life on July the 2nd in Dublin. I'll read out a few more later, but it's absolutely fantastic having the bishops on board. Okay. I'm still told that people can't hear me. We'll have the official attendance soon. Eamon, who's in the crowd somewhere, will bring it up to me at some stage. Eamon is a mathematician from Cork, so we hope that anyway. So, again, is people there in the middle? People with the Youth Defence Keep Ireland Abortion Free banner, can you hear me there, can you? Do you know which banners you have? No, probably not. If you look around to the front of your banner, please. And because people are saying we find it hard to hear us. Okay.
Next talk, speaker. Have you got Daniel's? Let's get the intro ready. Okay, this man next is a man of mystery. Because I don't have an intro for him. Oren's going to get the intro.
What can we say about good old Daniel? Daniel is a wee Belfast man. He's a great young worker, and he's, I don't know if any of you have seen the Lent for Life devotions that were prepared up in the north. It was Daniel here himself who wrote them. There was people coming all over the place wanting to know who wrote them. It was this young man here. Give him a big round of applause. Daniel McCabe.
Whoa! It's great to see so many of our pro-leg youth here today. I'm certain you all have voices which are very much in tune. So if I shout culture, you shout of life. Culture!
Life.
Culture!
Life.
Culture!
Life.
Now be on your guard, because I may just shout culture again sometime soon. So get ready to show off those voices. Firstly, I will introduce myself. My name is Daniel McCabe, I'm 19 years old, and I'm soon to be studying medicine at Queen's University Belfast. I'm a youth member of Precious Life, where I volunteer as a prayer warrior outside the abortion referral agency in Belfast. My role as a prayer warrior is to support our counsellors who help parents in a crisis pregnancy. I do this through prayer and fasting. I also help with community outreach, which is vitally, vitally important in educating the public, especially the youth, about the threats to unborn child and mothers, and to raise an awareness of the need for the youth of Ireland, you, to take a stand against abortion, as St. Paul asked the Ephesians. Now, whether you know this or not, you're all here today, thank you, Bernie, for the very same reason, and that is because God the Father has called each of you by your name to take a stand against legalised abortion in Ireland. You have been called here today to spread a message of life to Ireland and to the world, and what a beautiful thing, am I right? So today I'm not speaking as a pro-life youth, but an active pro-life youth to my fellow pro-life brothers and sisters. I'm asking each of you to be the new generation of pro-life leaders in Ireland and push back the gates of the culture of death. Do this boldly, with great humility and total dependence on God, because you, each of you, can do all things through God who lives in you. And those who want to murder our unborn children of Ireland have no power greater than that which is in you, the power of God the Father. From Matthew's Gospel, you find these words, "You are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and never will the powers of death overcome it," end quote. Now let's not allow the culture of death to overcome this country, Ireland, and the lives of our future children. But this will not happen unless we, you and I, take a stand and be on the front line of the battle, a battle which is ours, as we were born for this generation at this time. When the greatest crime against humanity is unnoticed by many, and how will we stand together? We will stand for a culture!
A life.
A culture!
A life.
A what culture?
A life.
Very good. Now, you, the Irish pro-life youth, will shake the world by your example until it awakens and the culture of death is no more. From the words of Pope John Paul, place your intelligence, your talents, your enthusiasm, your compassion, your ambitions, your sports and your studies to the fortitude on the service of life, and do so with great joy. The culture of death has become normality in this world. It's become accepted in the minds of many young people. This has been a direct result of legalised abortion on demand. Once the inviolable right of every human life, every human being to life becomes degraded, which was never set by man in the first instance, will result in a mankind not able to fulfil and sustain its vocation as children of God, made in his image and his likeness, but will lead to destructive generations of man with darkened minds in relation to each human life and the entire human family as one. This mankind will never find peace. But right now, Jesus whispers in your heart and mine, "You did not choose me, but I chose and appointed you." He is calling us to tackle more and more to the culture of death and to embrace it. Young people of Ireland, share with others the great yes that you have accepted to life, as the world is in need of this light and of this truth. And yes, today is a great day. It's a day of celebration where each of us feel comfortable. A day to celebrate life in all its God-given beauty. But what will tomorrow bring when we are not with our fellow pro-life brothers and sisters? Therefore, Christ needs each of you, every one of you, to enlighten the world and show it the path of life, as Psalm 16 proclaims. So we're going to stand for a culture
of life.
But the battle I'm asking you to accept will not be easy. It will be a struggle, as the culture of death whispers many lies to the hearts of the young. But take joy in Christ, because Christ needs your youth, and he needs your enthusiasm to make his proclamation of life resound in this country, Ireland, and in the world. Answer his call by placing your lives at his service through pro-life activism, and trust Christ, because he trusts each and every one of you. And finally, I would like to finish with a personal story. One day, I was with Bernadette outside the family planning clinic in Belfast, and a sudden fear came upon me. It was as if I was being told I cannot be effective in any way to save the life of an unborn child and a mother. But Bernadette quickly supported me through these words of scripture. Alas, Lord God, behold, I do not know how to speak because I am a youth. End quote. These words are from Jeremiah when he complained to the Lord that he cannot be effective in converting the hearts of others. But I can tell you that when you do meet a mother who has no one to turn to as she enters an abortion referral agency, confused, hurt, and believing that abortion is her only option, and you are the one who is there for her as she enters that clinic. I have never experienced a greater joy in my life than to gently guide a mother away from the clinic to a place where she will be safe and where she will choose life for her motherhood and her baby. It is a great blessing from God to experience such a joy. And so I pray that the Lord may create in each, every person here, every young person, a fire of perfect love and charity, because by the power of the Holy Spirit, we will be effective in witnessing to the gospel of life. And I pray that he may bless each of us with the same faith of young Jeremiah, so we may actively tackle abortion from becoming legalized in this country. Thank you.
Three cheers for Daniel. Hip hip! Hip hip! We're turning to the person next year, right? Turning to the person next year, we're going to try a simultaneous high five. Because, as we know, there's well over 1,790 here. So we're going to try and break this record, okay? So if everybody turns, you know what a high five is? I'm going to show you a high five there. That's a high five, okay? But it has to be done simultaneously. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, high five, okay? Young and old, here we go. Are you ready? So you all turn to somebody. Everybody turn to somebody. Put your hands up in the air, okay? Hands up in the air. At the back, hands up in the air. Can you hear me? Hands up in the air, right? Turn to your friend, okay? On the count of three. One, two, three. We'll try it once more, and when we hit hands, go high five. One, two, three, high five. Be up on YouTube, okay? So we'll see what we can do, right? Guinness were too expensive to get here. They cost me $6,000 to get here to confirm that world record. But we'll take it anyway. We'll call it the Beamish world record. Right, now. Next up we have Dana Rosemary Scallon. A lady who needs no introduction. Dana is Ireland's first Eurovision winner, a much-loved singer and television personality. Dana has also been to the fore in speaking out for life and family. As MEP for Connacht Ulster, Dana was a key figure in raising pro-life issues and defending the right to life in the European Parliament. She has always come true for the unborn, and we are delighted to have her here today. Ladies and gentlemen, your pro-life politician, Dana Rosemary Scallon.
Thank you very much. Isn't it wonderful to be here?
Yes.
And you always know pro-life people because they're celebrating life.
Yes.
We are from every corner of this country, and people have come from outside of Ireland as well. But every corner of Ireland is represented here, and every kind of pro-life group. And that's a wonderful thing, because it is all of Ireland united for life. And I congratulate everyone involved in organizing this and everyone involved in making the effort to be here. We are here outside the door, where people elected by us are responsible to us. Our constitution belongs to the people. it does not belong to the Dáil. It does not belong to the people elected in the Dáil. It belongs to the people. And the majority of people in this country do not want legalized abortion in Ireland. Europe has no right to force abortion upon the people of this country. None of the bodies in Europe have the right to force this nation to have legalized abortion to kill their children. Europe, keep out of the Constitution of Ireland that belongs to the people. And we call on the politicians we have elected to respect the voice and the wishes of the people of this country as they express it, but as it is contained and protected in our Constitution. You are a wonderful people. I really am privileged to be with you today. And we certainly are a culture. Thank you.
Before Dana goes, three cheers to Dana. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! So I'm going to ask Dana just to make the draw. We have three, everybody filled out a form, or some of you filled out a form. So I'm going to ask Dana to pick out three winners.
Myra Hickey from Bally, yes, County Limerick, Ballyneety. Myra Hickey from Ballyneety, County Limerick. Anne Nixon from Dundalk. Deliberately picking out women only. And to prove it, John Roach from Enniscorthy. Thank you.
Precious Life was founded in 1995 and has become up north the most successful and active pro-life organisation. She has been credited with bringing politicians from every party together to ensure that the 1967 Act has not been extended to the north of our country. Precious Life are hugely active in public engagement, creating awareness and educating the public to build a pro-life society. Bernadette is a tremendous pro-life activist and a great friend. And we are delighted to have her today at the All-Ireland Rally for Life. Please give a warm welcome, Bernadette Smith, everybody.
Well, thank you all for coming here today. And we have listened to Daniel, we have listened to Carolyn, and we've listened to Dana. And Ireland remains abortion-free because of the sacrifice of people, and many of you people here today sacrifice your lives, sacrifice your finances, and sacrifice your time. So we are here today to thank you also for all the work that you do for the babies in Ireland, and for the support that you show us. Because of that support, I can say to you that Ireland continues to be the light in this global battle against abortion in the world today. We are winning this battle for our unborn, and we are holding back the floodgates. And because of you, the people of Ireland, you are a people of life, and you are a people of light. And we say today, unified, united, that we will never accept the killing
of our unborn children. In Ireland today, we are winning the battle on the streets. We are winning the battle in the courts. And we are winning the battle through the government. And I can say to you today that the Northern Ireland Stormont government is the most pro-life government in Europe. Are we a people of life?
Yes.
And we wonder how, and throughout the whole of Europe, is steeped in the blood of innocent children. And we asked ourselves, why does Ireland remain abortion free? And I will say to you that we, the people of Ireland, have the spirit of St. Patrick in our veins. And that light that he lit on the hill of Tara all those years ago is still lit today in Ireland.
And enthusiasm generated by last July's Rally for Life in Belfast. I am confident that this year's rally in Dublin will be equally successful in highlighting the sanctity of human life from conception to natural death. I also like to read out a few words from the pro-life campaign. Three cheers for the pro-life campaign. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! The pro-life campaign wishing the Rally for Life all the very best. There are many serious challenges facing the pro-life movement in the coming months, and we must be united in our resolve to preserve Ireland's unique pro-life ethos, which protects mother and their unborn babies. With every good wish from the pro-life campaign. Right. Our final speaker today is Níomhnic Fiadhúna from the Life Institute. Níomhnic Fiadhúna was here. Niamh O'Brien, my apologies. Niamh was here in 1992 as a young girl telling us that she would not be silent and she would not give up keeping Ireland abortion free. 19 years on, Niamh is still working every day to fight against abortion. Niamh handed over the reins of Youth Defence to the young people who organised most of this rally today. And three cheers for them as well. We have to give the office a big cheer. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! That's all the bus grassroots organisers. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
So after Niamh handed the reins over to youth, of youth defence to younger people, she set up with other older youth defenders the group Life Institute. Life Institute is a group that informs people basically what's going on through websites, through press releases, through education, through leaflets, through meetings, etc. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Niamh O'Brien!
Can you all hear me? Okay, a greedy Ushla. Creature fear all his own revenge on you. Let him slew a Eatuksha. A Honigamach and Kinchu, Gamach Aaron, fear of Ginvilla. Ladies and gentlemen, it is just wonderful to be here on this great day, to stand with all of you at this powerful rally for life, at which we tell our people, our government, with one united voice, we will keep Ireland abortion free. I'm so happy to tell you that this is the biggest rally for life yet. Our early estimates are between 7,000 and 8,000 people. Because the Irish people want to send a message to this government. And the message is that we will not accept the legalisation of abortion. Not now, not ever, not in our country and not in our name. So let's have a cheer, first of all, for the man above, for this bright and sunny day, which is just perfect for celebrating life. And let's have a cheer, let's face it, for the young people of Youth Defence who've barely gone to bed for the last month to organise the Rally for Life. Hip hip! But most of all, let's hear it for each and every one of you who came here today to keep Ireland abortion free. Hip hip! Huge numbers is great news for mothers and babies, because mothers and babies deserve better than abortion, and in Ireland we can do better for them than allowing the abortion industry to set up shop to kill children and exploit women. And because when the pro-life movement is engaged and determined and unified, it can, against all the odds, protect human life, our most precious gift, from the moment of conception, and we will not take no for an answer. Human Rights ruled on a case which had been designed and sponsored by International Planned Parenthood, the world's largest abortion providers, and a thoroughly creepy bunch of people. And the aim of the case was to force Ireland to legalise abortion. And when the European Court made their ruling, the Labour Party, to their shame, rushed out to call for abortion on demand. Eamon Gilmore wanted Ireland to follow the British law. The model that kills 190,000 babies every year, where Mary Stopes offers lunchtime abortions, and where tragically 95% of babies with Down syndrome are killed. But the pro-life movement united around this country, and in a major nationwide push, we made sure that every voter in the country knew exactly what Labour's plans for our children were. And their vote fell by up to 30%, because even in the midst of this terrible recession, the Irish people know that life is precious, and that abortion is never a solution to any problem. So we're here today to send a special urgent message to Taoiseach Enda Kenny. First of all, Enda, keep your pro-life promise. You said during election 2011 that Fianna Gael were opposed to the legalisation of abortion. We're here to make sure you keep your word. And Fianna Gael say they're setting up an expert group to look at the European Court ruling. And we, the pro-life majority, are telling you, here and now, and every day going forward, that we will not accept a committee that is either stacked against the unborn child or that ignores the evidence that clearly shows that abortion is never medically necessary. We demand transparency, we demand honesty, and we demand that you listen to the pro-life majority who say yes to life and no to abortion. Surely as Labour's did in the last election. the guts to legalise abortion. Now I'm going to call this exactly what it was. It was a manipulative, deceptive, dishonest attempt to portray abortion pushers as the champions of courage. They are precisely the opposite. Because what courage does it require to kill a helpless baby? What courage does it require to exploit and abuse women for profit? And what courage does it require to answer a crisis only with the violence of abortion? No courage whatsoever! And the European Court has utterly discredited itself by linking abortion, the deliberate killing of helpless children, with human rights. The fact is that the human rights of every human being, of you, of me, of everybody, begins at the moment of conception. And it is Ireland that has shown courage in dealing with abortion. By protecting both our mothers and babies, we have made Ireland the safest country in the world for a mother to have a baby, and we should be proud of that achievement. Because together we can be an unstoppable force for life that will make abortion history. And Ireland is deep in recession, and our country is being ruled by the EU and the IMF, who are inflicting savage cuts on the most vulnerable people in this nation. So the abortion campaigners and their fellow travellers in the Labour Party think they can exploit the pain of this nation by attacking our pro-life laws when they feel we are most occupied with other concerns. They may even think, as that great Irish hero Pádraig Mac Piarse wrote, that they have purchased half of us and intimidated the other half. They may think that they have foreseen everything, think that they have provided against everything. And you'll all know this part, the fools, the fools, the fools, they are absolutely and utterly wrong. And we are here today to tell them that they are wrong and that we will keep Ireland abortion free. It shall be written in our hearts, and we will speak it loudly and clearly. We